Hi, the flower that I'm sharing with you today is a cyclamen. Mine have come up in abundance and it's a very bright pink flower with a lot of strong energetic qualities about it. If you look at the way a cyclamen grows, they actually grow on a bit of an angle. They grow they almost come out sideways, don't they? They're doing their own little thing. And that is the message, quite frankly, of a cyclamen. It's about self-nurture, doing things your own way, and looking at those inner core sort of beliefs, your own feelings, making sure that you give those space. Lots of things about self there. So we'll touch on that a bit later as well through the drawing. Now when I'm drawing, I'm looking at the flower, seeing how that relates. And I do an overall sort of sketch out of the shape to start with. I have been asked that many times, does spirit guide me? Do I channel the drawings? Well, I draw what I see. And I do. I do get an inclination to make some features a little bit more prominent than others. And when we talk about the language of flowers, or some people call it the doctrine of signatures, they're the sort of things that we're really sort of looking at, is that the things that are different, the things that indicate the flower and the flower and the plant's energies as well. So I'm sort of being guided to notice some parts more than the other. When I'm doing this, I'm really guided at the moment with this actual plant to take a really good look at the veins of the leaves and the direction, obviously, of the cyclamen as well. So I sketch it out first in pencil, really quite roughly, as you can see. These are really quick sketches that I do in the mornings. After I do that, I'll come in with a little bit of line work. Now, same thing, these are not, I was going to say there's nothing wrong with them. Of course there's nothing wrong with them. These are not the sort of artwork that I use to create my lino cuts. They're the start of it. They're the start of the exploration of them. But they're very much, as I said, very quick, little almost character sketches of the plant. So I'll put in that sort of that line work there. I'm just really concentrating on what is different, what is important, what I want to emphasize with this line work. This isn't botanical illustration. For those of you who do botanical illustration, this to me, these are energetic sketches. So I'll get to that point with my cyclamen. And then I'll rub out all that pencil work. There we go. I'm trying to work quickly here because the YouTube has got such a limitation on time, don't they, really? And then I'm bringing my beautiful cyclamen back and putting in the colours that I see. Cyclamen, self-nurture, listening to that inner voice, and there's a lot of self-healing here. I mean, you can see that from the colours, the beautiful pinks there. This one has lovely tinges of white here in different shapes, and we might even read those shapes when we're flower reading. So I put colours in like that. I use Prismacolors. These are wax-based pencils to do my morning sketches because of the blending abilities. Really, really, really love Prismas. You know, people who've used them, they can be painful because they do break. But they're just so lovely. And so I'm really making a big effort to have a look there. Up you go. You're very jumpy this morning, cyclamen. you so much for your presence. Now I'm looking for a bit of a purpley, because there is purple in that flower, so we can see that there. I have a strong feeling to indicate the end there really, really well. So these are my morning sketches. As I said, they're not, look, they might hang on Great Wall somewhere. No, I don't think so. But they're my morning sketches that I use to come over here and keep almost throwing you over there, don't I? I think you want to run over there with my, I think you want to run out the window with the birds singing out there. These are quick little indications, as I said, of the energy of the plant. I'm really drawn to the purples that are in this at the moment. And then those of you who also paint and draw, love prismas, you know the beauty of the blending. I don't blend with the colourless blender. I don't know, I like this. It sort of gives it a sort of ethereal quality, I think. Okay, so I've pretty much got the colour down. You can tell I like the white. I have a few going at once, really. Love them. So I've got the colour down there with my little cyclamen, and then I'm working in as well with the leaves. I want to get that down as well. And I'm really feeling that. Like, I'm just feeling the energy. This is a really, I don't know, it's all about self-nurturing, finding space for yourself. And you would think a bit of a quieter flower, but this actual one this morning, she's a bouncy bounce, which is great. Oh, don't waste your prismas when you break them. So putting that all in, it's sort of turning into a little drawing lesson, isn't it, really? So putting some more of those colors in. I'm really focusing on those little veins there that are in there, so I'm putting those in. Okay, now we'll just get a little bit of that darker sort of color that's in the cyclamen leaf. And the same thing, blending really well in there. Now, I could spend hours doing this all day. It'd be great, wouldn't it? Yes, it would. I would love it. Love it, love it, love it. So blending the colours really well in. It's my scribble phase, my scribbly scribble phase. Okay. Oh, so really sort of getting there now and indicating that leaf. Now, I don't choose the flower that I sketch in my journal willy-nilly. Sometimes I ask you, so you know that. I've come online and sort of just asked if there's someone that would like me to draw a flower of the day. Love doing that. Love sharing those sorts of things. And I'm just drawn to do that sometimes, because sometimes I think, well, maybe somebody needs to see what the flower of the day is. And sometimes I do it because it's what I'm working on at the moment, and I feel like whatever the thing is that I'm working on at the moment could be of relevance to somebody else or other work that could come forward as well. So I just need to sort of focus a little bit more. It's not the color I wanted. I need to focus a little bit more. This is the jumpiest cyclamen in the world. It's been wanting me to toss it in the air, and it's been jumping around by itself. There we go. So that's that. And then I come in and put highlights in. Remember when I told you about that lovely, the white that I really noticed there? So I'm really going to sort of indicate that there. And yeah, I use a gel pen for that. Now I have this really weird gel pen technique. It's called finger dabbing that I use to blend it in a little bit. So that was me concentrating. It's concentrating on my cyclamen. There we go. And the same with leaves. Again, remember I told you I'm really, really just so fascinated today. I'm going to have to really think about why and have a really good look at that later. So I put all those veins in because they're really important. And highlighting down there. That's it. sort of squidge it in. That's my technical term, squidging. That's it. Really want to indicate that white there. That's really, really important. Oh, okay. And then a little bit of shading. I use a 5B pencil. Lead pencil to do that. Oh, the gel pen that I use is a Uni-ball. Like, oh, there's, I think it's a really, really good one. I was about to say it's the best one ever. There's some really good ones out there, but that one's definitely a good one. There we go. And then I'm just one of those people that loves, I love shading and I love the light. And that's all I do. I use one of these and I use a little touche on. So I used to be a pastelist, so I love these. Just don't go too hard, otherwise you just rip your page and your paper. And that gives me just a little bit of dimension. Now, I've been jibber-jabbering on, or trying to jibber-jabber on and hurry so I can make this fit the schedule. So that's like the quickest one. Usually take a little bit longer than that, I have to admit. Probably double the time because I sit and think and really examine the flower. I was sitting there this morning looking at that flower before I came inside. And I thought, this is the one for me. So then I will notice the things that really popped out. And as I said, I had that white patterning on the flower that really seemed to make sense to me when I began. And we're looking at Cyclamens being about what's within us, our inner core coming out. So I loved the fact that that's what that was all about. There's a lot of light here coming out and on the edges of this beautiful, beautiful flower. I also really liked the fact that I was looking at this purple base here. My flower reading students will tell you, so we're looking at the color as well and what the importance of that color is. So of course we're looking at things that have to do with our intuition and sort of our higher thinking and probably aligning with things that are very spiritually based as well. Cyclamens also indicate a need to focus on what you're doing and not to give in to external pressures and demands that are probably run their course. It's time to sort of say, well, hang on a minute, I've got something I need to do at the moment and I need to move forward on it. So that's another thing. It's also about putting that whole mind, body, spirit, heart and soul balance in order. So it's a time for that. So I always find it interesting that cyclamens come up, especially in this area, right when the seasons start to turn. I was speaking to a good friend yesterday about the unusual flowers that are flowering at the moment. So I felt really fantastic that I had this bank of cyclamens all come up in my garden, because that's right. And cyclamen is about things being in balance and order and being nurtured and moving back to that place. So I felt really like this a little bit of a shift to normality and to the cycles working the way they should. So that's how I actually do my little wildflower sketches of the day. And then I do scan them and then I make them into a little card as well. I don't change anything other than that. Don't change the artwork or anything. So that's it. So I hope you enjoyed seeing how this one was made today. Have a fantastic day. And because it's a cyclamen day, take care of yourself and make sure that you nurture that inner voice inside you. Happy blessings.